this thing is a slot machine. Every time I check my phone, I'm playing the slot machine to see, what did I get? This is one way to hijack people's minds and create a habit, to form a habit. What you do is you make it so when someone pulls a lever, sometimes they get a reward, an exciting reward. And it turns out that this design technique can be embedded inside of all these products. So
sure.
There's a whole playbook of techniques that get used to get you using for the product for as long as possible. So Snapchat's the most popular messaging service for teenagers, and they invented this feature called Streaks, which shows the number of days in a row that you've sent a message back and forth with someone. And so you could ask, when these features are being designed, are they designed to most help people live their life? Or are they being designed because they're best at hooking people into using the product? They are programming people. There's always this narrative that technology is neutral and it's up to us to choose how we use it.
Technology is not neutral.
It's not neutral. They want you to use it in particular ways and for long periods of time because that's how they make their money. Look, never before in history have a handful of people at a handful of technology companies shaped how a billion people think and feel every day with the choices they make about these screens. And it's not because anyone is evil or has bad intentions, it's because the game is getting attention at all costs. And the problem is it becomes this race to the bottom of the brainstem.
You call this a race to the bottom of the brainstem. It's a race to the most primitive emotions we have, fear, anxiety, loneliness, yeah. All these things.
Absolutely, and that's again because in the race for attention, I have to do whatever works.
A computer programmer who now understands how the brain works knows how to write code that will get the brain to do certain things. You don't pay for Facebook. Advertisers pay for Facebook. You get to use it for free because your eyeballs are what's being sold there.
Brown says there's a reason texts and Facebook use a continuous scroll, because it's a proven way to keep you searching longer.
You spend half your time on Facebook just scrolling to find one good piece worth looking at. It's happening because they are engineered to become addictive.
You're almost saying like there's an addiction code.
Yeah, that is the case. Since we've figured out, to some extent, how these pieces of the brain that handle addiction are working, people have figured out how to juice them further and how to bake that information into apps.
Dinner table could be a technology-free zone.
While Brown is tapping into the power of dopamine, psychologist Larry Rosen and his team at California State University Dominguez Hills are researching the effect technology has on our anxiety levels. Rosen told us, when you put your phone down, your brain signals your adrenal gland to produce a burst of a hormone called cortisol. Cortisol triggers a fight or flight response to danger.
How does cortisol relate to a mobile device, a phone?
What we find is the typical person checks their phone every 15 minutes or less, and half of the time they check their phone, there's no alert, no notification. It's coming from inside their head telling them, gee, I haven't checked in Facebook in a while. I haven't checked on this Twitter feed for a while. I wonder if somebody commented on my Instagram post. That then generates cortisol, and it starts to make you anxious, and eventually your goal is to get rid of that anxiety, so you check in. When you put the phone down, you don't shut off your brain. You just put the phone down.
We found out just how anxious in this experiment conducted by Rosen's research colleague, Nancy Cheever. While I watched a video, a computer tracked minute changes in my heart rate and perspiration. Every time a text notification went off, the blue line spiked, indicating anxiety caused in part by the release of cortisol. Their research suggests our phones are keeping us in a continual state of anxiety.
Here's the reality. Corporations and creators of content have, since the beginning of time, wanted to make their content as engaging as possible.
Ramsey Brown and his garage startup Dopamine Labs made a habit-breaking app as well. It's called Space, and it creates a 12-second delay before any social media app launches.
And they rejected it from the App Store because they told us any app that would encourage people to use other apps or their iPhone less was unacceptable for distribution in the App Store.
They actually said that to you?
They said that to us. They did not want us to give out this thing that was going to make people less stuck on their phones.